everyone, Carol here at Oak House Journals. And as you can see, I've been having a little play date with myself working with my wax seals. And as you can see, I've been playing with leaves and flowers and pieces of vellum and, oh, just all sorts. I've done it on paper envelopes. I've put twine behind and I've even wrapped little parcels and used my stamps on the parcels. So I've had a fabulous, fabulous time. Nothing is perfect by any means, but the more I practice, the better I get. So I've been using all sorts of things this afternoon. In the main, I've been using my Craspire stamps, and this is my latest mermaid little brass rod. This is a maple leaf that I've had from them in the past, and I will do close-ups. I'm not going to show any of these now close-up. I'll do some photographs at the end for you to see, and you can see them in more detail. So really, the other stamps I've been using, oh, that one I didn't use. Now that's my clock one. Oh, what a shame. I'd completely forgotten about that one. There's my Starburst one here that I've been using. I've used my terrarium one, which is down here. And I've also used this lovely sprig of a plant. And that one comes out really, that's one of my abject fails, that one. I didn't put enough wax in. So I've been playing with all of those. What else have I been playing with? And my last two, I've been using my blank stamp. But what I also like about the brass rods is that you get the detail end and you get the plain end. So if you want a small one, you've got that on your rod. Or I have one that is an inch across. And then my last stamp was my B stamp, which is down here, as you can see. So I've been having a fine time. I've also been using these lovely markers, metallic markers that I got from Craspire. And as you can see, I've used them up here on my little black seals. As I showed in the unboxing video, they are gorgeous colours. The one thing I have learnt with them though is that you need to be patient, because they do take a wee while to dry. And I used the silver one recently in my Raining Woods journal, and it came out rather juicy. They all are very juicy. It came out rather juicy and it looked like that when it was dry. Now that was a bit too much on the seal that I did in my Raining Woods journal. And all I did whilst it was slightly damp was I just touched over the top with my finger very carefully, and it just softened it a little bit. And here on this one, I put silver on there first and then decided I needed to try another colour when it was dry. And I used the pink one over the top and it gave me this gorgeous, soft, delicate pink colour. Really liked that. So I've had fun with those and really enjoyed using them. I also have been having fun blending colours. Now, I haven't done that before. And I've used my little stirrer that I also got from Craspire, and that is lovely to use. I've really enjoyed doing playing with that. You'll also see me using some silicone moulds, and again, the description will be, all the details will be in the description box down below. So I've been using these to try and get better shapes, and it really has helped me. And the other thing that you'll see me using in the video is some glitter. All this is Paper Mania fine glitter, and I got this from Hobbycraft here in the UK, and just sprinkle that on the top. And the other thing that you'll see me use is my Avril twine. I've used some white here, I've used some plain cotton there, nothing more than plain cotton, and this is Avril twine as well. And again, the link will be in the description box down below. So I'm going to switch off the recording camera now, everybody, and just let you have some nice music as you see my efforts, and there'll be some photographs at the end. So thanks so much for watching, and take care. Bye-bye.